Okay, so today we look how to prepare for IES. IES is Indian Engineering Services. This is a central service for which recruitment is done by UPSC. They are conducting an exam known as Engineering Service Examination, ESE. So you might have heard about services like IES, IPS. They are the services for administration. Recruitment is also done by UPSC, and for IES also recruitment is done by UPSC. They are conducting an exam known as Engineering Service Exam for the recruitment. This is a technical service only for engineering graduates, only for BTech graduates. So they have allowed four branches. They are conducting the exam for four branches: civil, mechanical, electrical and electronics and communication. So these are the four core branches that they are offering, but allied branches to mechanical, like industrial engineering, production engineering, can also apply to mechanical engineering. Also, allied branches to electronics, like electronics and instrumentation and electronics and electrical, can also apply in electronics and telecommunication only. So now they are conducting the exam in three stages. There are three stages for the exam. First stage is preliminary. In preliminary, they are going to take two papers. One is going to be general aptitude. General aptitude consists of subjects like environment and project management aptitude. There are 10 generic subjects in general aptitude paper. Duration for this exam is going to be 2 hours, and this is going to be for 200 marks. Then there is going to be a technical paper. Technical paper is going to be for 3 hours and the weightage is 300 marks. Both these papers are going to be on the same day, most probably in January, and total of 500 marks they are going to judge you here. This technical paper consists of 12 to 14 subjects of your branch. For example, in ESE they have got 14 technical subjects, and both of these papers are going to be objective in nature, only objective. Then next stage we are going to have mains. In mains also there are two papers, paper 1 and paper 2. Both of these are going to be technical papers and they are going to be subjective in nature. Weightage of both the papers is going to be 300 marks. So they're going to conduct this preliminary in most probably January. They're going to give the result by February or March. If you clear the prelims, that is if you score almost, the cutoff is going to vary. Suppose you scored from 250 to 300 in this prelims paper, then you're eligible to appear in mains. This mains is most probably going to be in May. If you clear mains and prelims both combinedly, that is total from a total of 1100 marks, if you clear the cutoff, you are eligible to appear in the interview. Interview is going to be of 200 marks, and then they are going to give the final cutoff, and if you clear all these combinedly, then you are going to be selected for IES. Now, what services are you going to get in IES? IES has a lot of different departments. Mostly technical work of the center is going to be covered by IES. Also, this is a central service. Central service means you're not going to be allotted a single cadre. You're not going to be living in a single place for whole of your life. This is a central service. They're going to give frequent transfers and you'll have to work all over India. Services in this consist of most prominent services in this are in railways, store services, telecommunication department. A popular service from electronics and telecommunication is in signals department. Other than that, in civil you get border road organizations, PWD like work. Other departments are also there. Most favored services in either in telecommunication department or railways department. So you are going to do a work according to your branch in the same service. Also, one misconception is there. People generally completing their graduation, they try to focus both on GATE and IES at the same time. So I would like to point out that this is not possible. If you try to cover, see, the syllabus of GATE and IES, the syllabus is very having a lot of similarity. Syllabus is almost same for both of these subjects. It may have one to two subjects extra, and this has English and aptitude extra. Aptitude is also covered in IES, but English is extra in GATE and engineering maths is extra in GATE. These are not available in IES. Not so much importance is given to them in IES. Technical subjects are almost same, but the problem is GATE does not cover the topics completely. That is, it is not going to ask you questions from all the topics that they give in the syllabus. They are going to ask you questions from selected topics, but they are going to ask you conceptual questions and the same topics that they cover, they ask in deep. ES is not the same. They are not going to ask you very conceptual questions or very tough questions, but they are going to ask you questions from all the topics. So you here, you need to cover the syllabus completely. Syllabus completion is the focus here. Here, even if you prepare out of 8 technical subjects, even if you prepare 6 technical subjects, even if you leave 2 subjects, it is not a problem. But the topics you prepare, you need to prepare them completely and you need to know the concepts completely. Here, you may not know the concepts very well. You need to know the concepts very well for the mains, but for objective, the prelims, you just need to complete the syllabus. You need to study each and every topic that they have given in the syllabus. Plus here, questions are repeated frequently. Questions get repeated. But in GATE, they are going to design new questions every year. They are not going to repeat questions. Not repeated. So, although you might have heard that many people who clear GATE, who get good ranks in GATE, clear IES at the same time, same year. So, don't get distracted by that. Actually, you need to select for yourself what is more important. Either you want to prepare for PSUs or you want to go for MTech, or you are willing to give IES, that is through ESE. So, you need to be clear in your vision, what are you trying to do, and start accordingly, because syllabus may be same but preparation strategy is very different. You need to focus on syllabus completion and on practicing previous year questions if you are preparing for IES. Also, you can practice GATE previous year questions. Many GATE previous year questions are asked in IES directly. They are going to ask these questions directly in IES. Because see, time is less. They are going to give 3 hours. In 3 hours, you are required to answer almost 200 questions. So time for each question is very less. Whereas in GATE, they are asking only 60 questions and the paper is for 3 hours. So accordingly, these questions are not very easy. Whereas in ES, only you just see the question. Maybe you get a previous year question, you just tick mark. If it's a new question, you take very less time to answer. So preparation strategy for these is very different, and for ES you just need to complete the syllabus on time, have a very good revision strategy, because when you're going to give the paper, you need to remember all the formula, all the concepts, all the definition, all the units, everything. And if you practice more, it's better. The more you practice, the better result you are probably getting. For mains, this strategy is not going to work. For mains, you have to practice all the derivations also, all the concepts also, and good numericals also. In mains, they are going to give good level of paper. level of paper from objective to mains is a lot of difference. See, in prelims, they are only going to give objective questions and very level is also going to be very easy. But in mains, they are going to be, okay, and one more thing, from last year, they've introduced the concept of QCAB in mains. QCAB. What is QCAB? You're going to get a sheet of question paper and they're going to give you fixed space for answer writing also. In that sheet only, our questions will be printed. For suppose you're given a question, then you're given one sheet of paper to write your answer. So you have to complete your answer in one sheet of paper only. No, there is no scope for any mistakes. If you solve the question incorrectly, you strike it off, your paper is gone, your chance is gone. You have only one chance to answer each question, plus you have limited space. You cannot go on writing stories in mains now. Earlier people used to do this, now they have introduced the concept of QCAP. You only get limited space, you have to plan accordingly and finish your answer completely in that space. So for this year, it would be better if you also practice answer writing for mains. Only knowing the concepts may not help. And if you clear mains, if you clear prelims, for interview, there the interview is going to be technical as well as generic. They are also going to ask you questions from your technical, from your prospective branch, and also from your general knowledge.